God my Father, Jesus my Lord, today I am deeply depressed. I feel difficult even to smile. I used to laugh a lot, but not any longer. All the joy seems to have just vanished from my life. I feel difficult even to pray. I get very distracted. I feel I am just going through the motions, as if I am just fulfilling my obligations. My faith, Jesus, has become weak. My hope is dwindling. I feel like the Jews in the concentration camps today. Yes, like them, I believe in the sun even when it doesn't shine. I believe in love even when I don't experience it. And more than anything else, I want to tell you that I believe in you, even if I feel that you don't care. Lord Jesus, you are present here in this Eucharist. You know that we hadn't even heard of this virus till the end of last year. Today the infections and deaths caused by it have destroyed our life in such a way that we never experienced anything like this so far. Jesus, today our streets are deserted. Our churches are not visited anymore. Our schools are empty. Our stores and marketplaces do not have sufficient essential commodities. Millions of people are unemployed and without food. I just don't know how their kitchen functions, very especially the kitchens of migrant peoples and those people, our brothers and sisters, living in slums. Our economy is in ruins. Fear, anxiety, and a sense of hopelessness has overtaken us. We don't see the light at the distant end of the tunnel anymore. And the saddest part is it looks as if you don't care, Lord. Father and Jesus, actually our problem is that we have taken everything on ourselves. We believe that we are the masters of this world and our destiny. We are fighting our battles on our own. Father, you were with Joseph when he was sold, when in prison, and when he became the governor of Egypt. You went with Moses and the Israelites day and night, as cloud and the pillar of fire. Father, you had said through prophet Isaiah, "Be not afraid, be not dismayed. I'll be with you as you pass through the fire, the raging waters, and the swollen rivers. Nothing will harm you." And Jesus, during the Last Supper, you had promised, "I'll give you another helper who'll stay with you forever." When you ascended into heaven, you made a solemn promise, "I'll always be with you till the end of the ages." This world was supposed to be centered around you, a Christocentric world. Today we have made it a corona-centered world. Father, Jesus and the Holy Spirit, we invite you today into our homes, into our schools, into our churches, into our hospitals, healthcare centers, administrative offices. We invite you everywhere where there is suffering and death. Take control of everything and everyone. Lord, we ask you to fight our battles, to protect all of us, all those who are involved in this fight against the virus. Very specially, you inspire our health workers and inspire our leaders, church leaders and the civic leaders, to invest prudently in personnel, in medical facilities and in research facilities, so that we are not caught napping once again if this virus comes again. Father, we ask you to come with your Son and the Spirit, with our Blessed Mother, all the angels and saints, and take control of this world. Take control of our lives. Come with us, all those who are fighting this battle, those who are infected, those who are grieving because people have died in their families, our health workers, our leaders, as we journey through the valley of this virus. We know if you are with us, no harm will come to us. Come into our life, Lord Jesus, so that we face this tsunami. We ask you today to be with all those people who are suffering because of floods and landslides. We ask you to strengthen our knees when we kneel down in prayer, as we lift up our hands to pray to you. Jesus, touch our lips and give us the right words to pray. Fill our minds with your peace and fill our hearts with your love so that we can share it with everyone. We ask you, Jesus, to come at the earliest and to heal our lives and this planet. You are our Creator, Father, and our Master. Bring everything under your control, this world, all the people, and all the sickness. We ask this with faith and love in the most precious name of Jesus. Jesus, you are present here. Hear our prayer. Amen.
My Lord, my God. Lord Jesus, present in our midst in this Eucharist, we adore you, we praise you, we worship you. Thank you for inviting us for this Eucharistic adoration in the days that we are reflecting on our present predicament for the whole world and especially for our country, the COVID-19 epidemic. Lord, in the midst of anxieties, in the midst of troubles, in the midst of worries and great fear, we are all gathered here to worship you. We are all gathered here to praise you and adore you with a great hope that you will relieve every one of us, our whole nation and the whole world from the present pandemic. Lord, we remember gratefully what happened in the life of the disciples as it is narrated to us in the Gospel of Mark, chapter 4, verse 35 onwards. The miracle that you still the storm. Lord, we try to identify ourselves with the anxious disciples as we pray this evening. Lord, we pray for your guidance. We pray for the guidance of the Holy Spirit to pray to you. As St. Paul says, when we do not know how to pray, the Spirit Himself is crying from within our hearts, Abba, Father. Strengthened by the power of that Spirit, we worship you, Lord. We praise you. And we praise you with the following hymn, singing your praises and worshiping you, that you may deliver us from all fear, from all anxiety, and give us a great hope. Lord Jesus, your disciples, after a hectic day of work, were returning. They were traveling by a small boat, and you were there tired, perhaps, and sleeping in that boat. And as the travel proceeded, there was calm, quietness, a bit of joy. And they would say to themselves, the disciples, okay, fine, we are progressing. We are going ahead in our journey. And my dear Lord Jesus, that's how the world was traveling at the beginning of this year 2020. Everybody, every nation had its own plan. Every government could sing its own victory song of what they have achieved. And thus the journey of 2020 began. But within a short time, beginning from China, the COVID-19 virus started attacking country after country, nation after nation, individuals, groups, and finally now the whole human family. Lord, the disciples were rowing the boat. First, they managed by themselves. They used all the techniques that they had learned over their lifetime. And similarly, our governments, our health department, our health personnel, hospitals, yes, all tried their best. But Lord, as it happened to the disciples, a moment came. As we read in the Gospel, a great windstorm arose and the waves beat into the boat so that the boat was already swamped. Yes, Lord, an uncontrollable situation, a situation beyond human hands, and the disciples did not know what to do. All human efforts seemed not to bring much desired fruit, though a little success there and a little relief there is observed, but we are helpless. Yes, Lord, we are in the same situation like the apostles, not knowing what to do. Lord, we now ask you to tell us what to do, to tell us what to do. You are our friend. Therefore, we sing to you again, what a friend we have in Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for your advice. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Thank you, Lord. Yes, that's what the disciples did. When they have realized that they are exhausted all their techniques, all their knowledge, all their capacity, they turn to you. And they came to you, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing? Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" And we know the result, Lord. Jesus woke up, we read, rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still," and the wind ceased. Lord, this is the story of the disciples, the story of the disciples with you. Lord, we thank you for this. Thank you for making us learn that it is in prayer, that it is in being united with you, that it is by surrendering our situation to you that we can have a solution, that we can find peace, that we can find liberation from our incapacity. Lord, this is not only the story of the disciples of the past, this is also the story of our own days. Yes, Lord, In your presence, we now listen to a witness, a sharing from Father Raja Jagan.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, praise the Lord. I am so glad to greet and wish you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. May God be with you and bless you. My dear friends, Christian life cannot be lived without prayer. If you do not know how to pray, then we are not really Christians, because it's the prayer that leads us to God and His kingdom. That's a well-known saying. Prayer is the road to God and His kingdom. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, it is through prayer we make our intimate relationship with Christ and the church. It is through prayer we unite ourselves with the Lord and the church. So I am very sure it is by our prayer we can achieve anything in the world. Yes, now I am going to share my prayer testimony with you all. In 2014, I was appointed as the parish priest in one of the parishes in my diocese, Sivakamkai. That was my first appointment as the parish priest. In the beginning, I was so glad and happy to get that appointment, because it was my first appointment. But when I had received the appointment order, some of the priests came and started mocking at me and discouraging me, saying, "Don't go to that parish," because that parish was closed almost 2 years. This is your first appointment. If you go there, naturally you will suffer like anything else. You cannot manage. You cannot do anything. So just go to the bishop's house and say to the bishop, "I will not go." But I told them, "No, this was my first appointment. So I will take it as a challenge and I will go. With God's blessing, surely I can do something there." My dear brothers and sisters, but with that intention, I entered the parish. But that time, really, it was shocking for me. Nobody was there to welcome me, but rather they all gathered together and asked me, "Why did you come here, Father? You need not be here. Immediately take all your luggage and go back to the diocese. We don't want any priest here." Hearing this, I was really disturbed and also discouraged, but I never lost my hope. Because I'm very sure of the verse in the Psalms, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is on my side, He is my helper." So with the confidence, just I went to the convent. I called all the sisters, "Sisters, please do come. Today evening we have adoration. So we all sit together and we can pray for our church." So my dear brothers and sisters, that day evening with the sisters, we have started the chain adoration. It went on not 1 day, 2 days, almost 3 weeks we were together in front of the Blessed Sacrament, praise and worshipping, praying for the church, praying for the people, praying for the repentance of the people. My dear brothers and sisters, really it was a good news for us all. On the fourth day, some of the parishioners turned their side. Looking at me, they said, "Praise the Lord, Father." My heart really glorifies the Lord. the hearing the word praise the Lord. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, I too with my sisters praise the Lord, because He only did that marvelous in the minds of the people. There was a conversion in the mind of the people. Almost 90% of the people turned towards the church. Now the church is at peace. All the sacraments are taking place. Every day the liturgical celebrations are celebrated in a magnificent way. So people are so happy, and now they glorify the Lord. Everything is possible through prayer. So by prayer, we can do anything in the world. Yes, my dears, pray, then you can achieve everything.
Yes, Lord. Father Jagan was in a difficult situation. The parishioners would not accept him, and there his only way is to come to you. Totally abandon himself into your hands, putting all his worries into your hands, he prayed. Lord, he united himself to you in prayer. And the moment he surrendered himself to you, you gave him liberation. You put order in that parish. People began to like him. People began to cooperate with him. And today he says he is a very happy priest in that parish. Lord, we praise you. We thank you. When we unite ourselves in prayer, when we come to you in supplication, yes, Lord, like the disciples of the gospel story, we are sure to find the solution for our problems. The peace that we look for is available with you, because you are peace, you are joy. Thank you, Lord, for this great moment. We thank you, we praise you, we adore you, because you are God of peace. You are our Savior from all distress and from all problems, including COVID-19 pandemic. Thank you, Lord. And now we are going to listen to the witness of Father Lionel from Thanjavur Diocese.
Praise the Lord. My dear sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, through this video testimony, I would like to share with you my profound prayer experience. How prayer unites us with Christ. A few years after my priestly ordination, I was appointed as the parish priest of a small village parish in my diocese of Thanjavur in South India. I took charge of this parish with lots of vision. This parish was very much dependent upon rain for their cultivation and for their livelihood. When I took charge of this parish, there was no rain for a few months. Therefore, the people requested me to pray for rain. I prayed along with the people. We said novenas, but there was no rain. To make this testimony shorter, people started grumbling and murmuring against me. We prayed and it did not rain. What is this priest doing? To make the things worse, some people mobilized to write a petition against me to the then Archbishop of my diocese, saying him that as long as this priest remains here in this parish, we will not get rain, therefore transfer him. When I heard this, I was very much offended. I was wounded. I knelt before the Blessed Sacrament and wept bitterly. Lord, why this is happening to me? During this time of prayer, I got a very strong inner inspiration, the Lord revealing to me, Lionel, I am going to make you a witness in this parish and in this diocese. All the people of this parish will testify for me. I read passages from the scripture, especially the first book of Kings, chapter 18, where we read about the prayer of Prophet Elijah on Mount Carmel for rain. I declared a day of fasting and prayer for rain. Although the people murmured against me, they listened to me. After the Eucharistic adoration, I said, Lord, thank you very much for giving us rain this day. When I came out of the church, I looked at the sky. There was absolutely no sign of rain at all. I was very much hungry, but I could not eat. I was very tired, but I could not sleep. I was rolling on my bed, kneeling by the side of my bed and praying, Lord, at least give me few drops of rain. But there was no rain. Early morning, 3 o'clock, I heard a small thunder noise that gave me some confidence. Just like Prophet Elijah, looking at the small cloud, he began to pray again. So I also knelt by the side of my bed and prayed again. You will not believe, early morning, 4 o'clock, it started pouring down, heavy downpour of rain, real Indian monsoon rain. In this parish, we used to have mass early morning, 5:15 a.m. When the people came for the mass, they were all drenched, they were all soaked in rain. But their faces were illumined, they were glowing. Even those who did not come for the church, they all came to the church, telling me, Father, the Lord heard our prayers. This is how the Lord draws everyone to himself. Prayer unites us with Christ. And this is a very powerful prayer experience in my life and the life of all the parishioners in that parish. And that should be the experience for you and for me all the time. So thank you very much for listening to this short video testimony. May God bless every one of you. Praise the Lord.
Lord Jesus, we thank you once again for the beautiful way you have acted in the life of Father Lionel. For no mistake of his own, he was disliked by his parishioners. He was almost pushed out of the parish because the people did not have rain in that place. Lord, not having rain is not the sin of the parish priest. But what can he do? And like the disciples of the story, he turned to you. He prayed to you day and night. And people joined him also in big numbers, continuously praying for good rains. And they had their answer. They had great showers, which would help very much in the agriculture of that area. Lord, you are great. When we turn to you in prayer, and when we unite ourselves with you, you begin to act. You act on nature, you act on human beings, and you act on every situation. Lord God, now we are praying for the same. The COVID-19 pandemic is destroying the health of people, the economy of the nations, and there are people who are very much affected psychologically, physically, and in their day-to-day life. Lord God, we present to you at this moment all the nations, all the affected people, all people who are getting treated, all people in the field of medicine and helping the patients to recover, and all the governments and their staff protecting people from getting infected with the virus. Lord God, we are very sure that you are going to liberate this world, save this world from this pandemic, of which everybody, from child to the elderly, are scared, afraid, affected, and finally disheartened. We offer all of them to you, Lord. You touch them, you heal them, and you are the victor. Destroy the virus, not only in one place, but all over the world, so that all peoples come to you singing their song of joy and say thank you, Lord, and praise you. And hoping that you are going to do this, believing that you will do this for us, Lord, we thank you once again. We praise you, we adore you, we glorify you. You know that you are powerful. Thank you, Lord. We are now going to listen another witness from Father Jay Bernard Joseph.
God is good all the time. God is good everywhere. And God is good to everyone. My dear friends in Christ, with immense joy, I would like to share with you one amazing faith story. 40 years ago, there was a family, teacher family, living a very good Christian life. They had 5 children, and once again, the mother was conceived with a 6th child. During that time, the Tamil Nadu government brought out a new rule that the teachers should reach out to the villages, giving awareness about family planning. It's a shocking news to this family, because how come the mother having 6 child can go and talk about family planning? Pretty sure the people would mock at her. So, because of this difficult situation, the parent decided to abort the child unwillingly. And she started taking some kind of a natural medicine. That time, there was a religious sister making house visit. She was visiting this family and found some kind of sadness in the family and trying to help the mother to tell the truth. Though the mother was hiding in the beginning the truth, but she broke out with emotion telling the truth that she was now in the process of aborting the child. Immediately, the religious sister pleaded the mother not to abort the child. And she was telling the teacher, you know what? This is not your child. This is God's child. Please let you not abort this. The mother accepted the sister's word and stopped taking medicine. And she regretted, asked sorry. And they were waiting for the child after some months. And the day when the child was born, on the one side, the family was so happy that they are going to receive another blessing, new child. But on the other side, they were worried and perplexed about how the child would be, because she took some medicine in the beginning, no? So the child may be mentally ill or physically disabled. So they were worried, and by God's grace, the child was born hale and healthy. So the mother was so happy, bringing up the child in faith, telling every time to the child, hey, you are not my child, you are God's child. This entered into the heart of that child. So that boy joined the seminary, and while he was doing first year theology, he got a very sad news, that his mother died by heart attack at the age of 56. You know what? It was a thunder for him. So he could not accept it. And after the burial of his mother, when he returned to the seminary, he decided to quit the seminary. So he was packing everything and ready to quit the seminary. That day was a weekend. So actually they used to have Eucharistic adoration in the evening. So with no interest, he went to the Eucharistic adoration. The brother was really sad and having heavy heart, painful heart. And he was simply letting out all his emotions with the anger against God. He was questioning the very existence of God. And while he was questioning God, the priest who was leading the Eucharistic adoration read the passage, Jeremiah 1:5. We all know, before you were formed in the womb of your mother, I knew you. Before you were born, I consecrated you. And he was continuing reading this passage, telling, hey brothers, you are not your mother's children. Rather, you are God's child. This was a great spark in the heart of that brother. This was a very profound experience. He sensed that as if God was answering his question. And the sentence which was told by the father, that was the same sentence given by his own mother. That is, you are not my child, you are God's child. That struck him. And he simply surrendered his life to the Lord and started continuing his seminary life. And he became a priest. And right now, he's a priest of 15 years standing in front of you. That is myself. I am Father J. Bernard Joseph. Dear friends, this is the power of prayer. When we express and lament and let out our emotions, God will answer. God will comfort. God will enlighten us. Praise be to the Lord. Thanks be to you for listening my faith story.
Lord God, we thank you, together with Father Bernard Joseph. He went through a very critical moment in his life at the passing of his mother. He was almost confused and deciding to go back on his vocation. And now, Lord, you intervened and you gave him that word. that I have chosen you before you were being formed in your mother's womb. Lord, that courage that you gave, that assurance that you gave, helped him to continue in his preparation for priesthood, and today he is very happy doing wonderful ministry in his diocese. Lord, as you would very, very often say, everywhere he goes, the Lord is good. God is good. Yes, Lord, you are good. You are good to those who believe in you. You are good to those who are in trouble. You are good to those who are in difficulty. Yes, Lord, you intervene in the life of individuals. You intervene in the life of families. You intervene in the life of nations. And we have many, many witnesses of this all along history. You are a living God, acted in the days past, and you are acting today. Once again, we come back to you, imploring your action, Lord Jesus, your intervention, Lord Jesus, in the coronavirus pandemic. Yes, Lord, we are helpless. We are unable, and we surrender to you. The whole human family, irrespective of religion, caste, and nation, we surrender to you. Lord, intervene. Lord, intervene with your great hand and power so that this COVID-19 pandemic disappears, becomes weaker, and people's life becomes happier. Yes, Lord, in Isaiah chapter 40, very strongly God said, "Do not be afraid, because I am there. Do not be afraid, your God is with you, and he will help you." And Lord, we believe. We believe like the man who said, "Increase my faith." We believe like your mother Mary, because she was appreciated by Elizabeth. "Great are you because you have believed that what is spoken by God will come to pass." Yes, Lord, we believe in your word. We believe in your promise. "Do not be afraid. I am there with you. I will help you. I will lead you. My right hand will give you freedom and peace." And for that peace, we are all looking forward to you, Lord. Lord Jesus, at this moment, we present before you all the priests and the bishops of the world. Lord, your sacred ministers, who have been called by you and who have left everything to follow you, are there in front of you. Very especially at this moment of COVID-19 pandemic, the priests and the bishops and all the ministers of the church are in a very hopeless situation. Churches are closed. Public worship is forbidden. And priests do not know how to help our people in this very difficult situation. Lord, I pray for those priests who have come out and was stood by those people were affected by the COVID-19 and they themselves lost their lives. A few bishops and a big number of priests, they have sacrificed their life in assisting their sheep, the people whom you have chosen. Lord, I pray for them all in a very special way. Grant them, Lord, eternal rest so that they would stand with you in praising the Father all the time. And at this moment, the priests, though they celebrate private masses, they are not able to celebrate the Eucharist with their people, which is a great pain for every minister. Lord, bless them all. Give them courage. Give them guidance how to spend these days of the lockdown and how to make use of their time for the benefit of the church and of the people. Bless all the priests. Priests who are very specially participating in this session, bless every one of them. Give them joy and happiness in their ministry, because at this period, many a priest is asking the question, what I am doing now as a priest? Lord, tell them that you pray. Pray for your people. Pray ardently for those who are affected, those who are infected, and those who are looking after the people in suffering. Yes, Lord, at this moment, our prayer is one of the best forms of our ministry. And bless every priest, bless every bishop, bless our Holy Father, Pope Francis, who is giving us a lead in this dark moment of history by his great faith and by signaling areas where we need to look up for help, especially to look upon the cross and to look upon our Blessed Mother. Bless all the religious men and women. Some of them are very active in this ministry at this time of the COVID-19, both in the field of healthcare and in the field of social help, economic help to the people who are affected. Bless them, Lord, and bless us all. Lord, accept our prayer, accept our supplication, and come to us, Lord, as we conclude this adoration. Come to our help and save us from all the devastating effects of the COVID-19 pandemic. Save every individual, save every family, save every business, save every economic activities of the nations. Lord, save the earth. Bless the earth and bless all of us. Thank you, Lord. We praise you. We adore you. We glorify you. And we bow before you, requesting, praying for your blessing.
Tanto ergo sacramentum venerem cernui et anticum documentum nova cedat ritui presepti resurrendo sensu Salud. trovo comparsit laudatio.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament left us a memorial of thy passion, grant, we implore thee, that we may so venerate the sacred mysteries of thy body and blood, as always to be conscious of the fruits of thy redemption, who live and reigns forever and ever.